Rah, rah, everybody say hee-ha. Yo, this is for the East side. Hey, from Vietnam to Vietnam and above and beyond. For Cholos and Chicas who roll in Toyota, Corolla, or Nissan. Provoking Hadoukens with Fofos and Levi's.
You know, art is a toss-up of so many things. I don't always want to receive a message from the art that I digest. Sometimes I just want to feel angry, or sometimes I just want to feel joyful, or I just want to grieve, or it's just a moment where I want to be cocky and I need to develop a sense of self and a sense of worth.
I want to be a Durham legend just like Nina Freeland.
What I love about hip hop is that generally there's like this omniscient hater, you know, anonymous hater in the world that's holding you down. In many ways, it's the system, many systems of oppression. And it often can be yourself, and it's an element of self-doubt. It always comes back down to the self to me. I guess when I think about as an Asian American and what I want to contribute to hip hop, it can't be a gimmick and it can't be a product. It's got to be truthful.
Feel the same things like say my name right, respect my everybody say Yama. Everybody say Zawa. Everybody
safe. We are at my parents' Japanese restaurant called Yamazushi. My parents came over from Japan in about 79. My childhood in Durham was, I think, equal parts standard and unique. I'm definitely a part of the time I grew up in. So, you know, Eminem and Dr. Dre and 50 Cent, and also a little brother. Luckily, someone put me on a little brother when I was like 12. And so that was a major influence in my life. So at first it was just all rap, and I just wanted to be the first Asian rapper, the greatest Asian rapper, and ultimately just the greatest, and you know, all MCs, they just have a competitive spirit. So when I was in eighth grade, well, there were homies around the neighborhood who were amazing at rapping, right? They were amazing, and we would just kick it, and we would freestyle. And in eighth grade, also one of my best friends had passed away. And that was the first time where it became more than just rapping. The fact that I could write about something and have a dialogue with myself about grief at a young age and also be able to process it beautifully. That's where like rap and writing and poetry began to sort of form as an actual foundation for like my mental health.
Y'all lickety split licking while I express my exquisiteness. Multiply to get the dividends. I never finished college, but I'm about to perform at Princeton and Old Dominion. I'm rapping to oblivion. Rap about the actual state of mind that you're living in and have the passion for penmanship. Woo!
It transformed into poetry when I was about 17 years old, when I went to my first national youth poetry competition and festival. And then I ended up competing on the Bull City Slam team when I was 18 under the tutelage of Tasana Hanu in the Haitai Center. Yeah, I'm definitely born and bred out of the grassroots poetry movement in North Carolina and Durham specifically.
You really need a practice to really see growth while you're working on your flow. I'll be working on my ad-libs. Big green on the track, what's good? Bull City, North Cat, what's good? Big teen in the lat, what's good? 15 in the back, what's good? Westside, worldwide, what's up?
We like to say writing is like 90% thinking. If you really carry the heart of a poet, any time of the day, you're kind of constantly thinking about the next piece or the piece at hand. When I decided I was going to write a poem about my grandma, anything I ever saw throughout the day would tie into, could this tie into this poem? Could this tie into this poem? What does bamboo mean to me and how does it relate to my grandmother? What does tablecloth mean to me and my grandmother? The poetry for me was a lot about Asian identity.
I'm a product of public education, yeah, but I learned the basics from my parents' Japanglish. Everybody got a story, you just gotta claim it. So I learned how to spit it in my mother's native language.
It was a lot about me finally appreciating and honoring my Japanese heritage and my family. You know, my parents were just so open with their culture, with their food, and with a sense of service and a sense of dignity of sharing a part of yourself with people. And then when it got to rap and it got to the album, it was like, all right, this is when I start to honor where I'm from.
Make some noise! If you know the words, I need some help, all right? Carolina barbecue sauce with the slaw. I'm the same, the cellar and the vault. I'm the best, the effect, and the cause on the law. It's the North Cat, baby, I'm a boss.
There's a lineage of hip-hop that comes out of North Carolina that I have to acknowledge. And it has to be present in me. It was less about saying, look at where I'm from, and this is all about where I'm from. And it was just about, yo, this is me, and I don't really care about anything else. And I just miss barbecue, and I miss putting slaw on it. I wanted to just show, you know, the heart of a Southern person. So many beautiful, beautiful people in the South, and Southern hospitality is a real thing. And North Carolina is always just filled with heart. Find me a Yamazushi, I toast for the finest sake. I promise you no more problems. You be nothing to handle. You should know I'm from Durham. It means there's nothing I can't do. Yo, this is G. Yamazawa, and North Carolina is the music state. Let's go up, y'all. I'm the best, the effect. In the cars, I'm the law. It's the North Cat, baby, I'm a boss. Come on, Carolina barbecue sauce with the slaw. I'm the sack, the cellar and the vault. I'm the best, the effect. In the cars, I'm the law. This is Jay Gunn. That's Armie Hammer on the ones and twos. My name is G. Yamazawa. Thank y'all so much, y'all. Y'all been beautiful. Make some noise for G. Yamazawa, Shakori Hills.